Good morning, good morning, good morning. It's Ruth Marquise, your favorite real estate agent. So, today we are talking about when is the right time to talk to a lender. My lenders know that before I send them over to someone, I talk to my clients before, you know, I send them over, I get to know them. If we don't know each other at first, because I do a lot of business online, and I find out more information, because I feel like everybody is different. Each person has their own situation, and each person should be dealt with, you know, separately. Good morning, good morning. So I like to get the background, the profile, like where you work and, you know, what you think. Hey.
I can't get in there.
Your credit score. Okay. You got that. Right. All right. Being hit on video also. Even in the suburbs, right? So I was talking about credit score. Like, I find out, like, what you think your credit score is, because, I mean, it may not be whatever you think it is, it may not be. But I think people have a general idea of what their credit score is. Sometimes it's kind of off when you look at Credit Karma. One day I'll talk about Credit Karma, but Credit Karma, I just don't believe it, man. I tell you, some people think they're higher than they are and they're lower. Some people are lower and they're higher, so it's better to just let the lender run your credit. But I don't like to send the people to a lender when they need to go to credit repair, or I know that their job history is a little shaky, or they're not working at all. Like, I don't want to waste anybody's time. So I don't want to waste your time or the lender's time. And so I get a profile on my clients, and that's what the 5-minute chat is about. And a lot of times we try to figure out, okay, when do I send them over to a lender? Some people don't know when they should talk to one. So that's what I'm talking about today. So, you know, I've preached a million times, you gotta be a 580 credit score minimum to buy a home. That doesn't guarantee that you're gonna buy a home, because if you have $90,000 student loan debt, $20,000 is all you make a year, and you got a 580, you're not getting a mortgage, because your debt is just way too high and your income is too low. And even though you have a 580, that probably will disqualify you. It's only one part. So when is the best time, right? So let's say you've been working somewhere for 2 years, even if it's been a couple different places, maybe two or three, you know, as long as you're staying in the same field, you know, you your credit, you know, you've been paying things on time, or you just really, if you're not sure, if you think you're closer to like a 550, then I would still send you over to the lender, because the lender has something called, they can pull a rapid on you. And it tells you exactly what you must pay in order to get your score to a 580. I started to switch up my strategy. Like, when people are saying, oh, I'm not a 580, I started to say, you know what? Some people are 550, and my lender tells them exactly what to do. You pay nothing. You don't have to pay for a credit repair. You don't have to pay anything. You just pay off the things that you need to pay. Because that's the other misconception. People say, oh, I'm gonna just pay the credit repair person. They ain't gonna take everything off my credit like it's magic. Anything that sounds like it's magic is not real. You know what I'm saying? So there are proper things that you should do. Now, let's just say that credit repair person takes everything off your credit, and then you get into a transaction, and one of those things, they disputed everything. One of those things come back. Like, you're risking losing the house and all the money that you put out. You've already put out $2,000 when you're buying a house up front, and now you're basing it off of credit repair and the wrong credit repair. And then, you know, you're stuck in a situation where you're losing money and you still can't buy a house. So I don't want that for you. I would prefer you get in good hands. The lender give you, like, this is the plan. Do this, A, B, and C, and you will be able to qualify for a house. And I always tell my lenders, let them know time frame, because people need to know how long, right? Am I 4 months away? Am I 2 months away? Am I 30 days away? Some people are just 30 days away. They have no credit score. I tell them to go get a secure credit card. They go do that, they buy a little gas, they pay it off, and boom, they got a 650. You know, some people, they have like all this bad stuff on their credit, and the best thing they can do is just get that secure credit card, and they're getting close. Like, if you're close, that 30 points matters. Like, And it'll be a bigger jump, like when you're just going from like your credit is like shaky to you try to, the first good step that you make, is that's the biggest increase you're gonna see. And when you get to a certain amount, it starts to be slower. So that's why it's like, I like to send people, if you're 550 over to a lender, because you just might be, because Credit Karma basically tells you a score that's a little lower than what it really is sometimes. So if you think you're a 560 and you're a 570, so now all you need is 10 points. You know what I'm saying? So the lender can tell you how to get that 10 points. But when you call a lender, don't call them when you have no money, because when they're telling you what you need to fix, it's gonna be you paying something off. They'll say like something like, pay your credit card off to like, you have a $500 limit, pay it down to a 250 and then you'll be fine, you know, and then you can qualify for a house. So it's not even if you qualify a house, it's when. Unless you know your credit is just, everybody like, my credit is bad. And like, what's bad credit? And they'd be like 640 or 620 or 582, it's bad. But you didn't know you could buy a house with that. Remember that the government wants you to buy a house. They want you to purchase a house. So they're making it easy with this FHA thing. So they're kind of relaxing their standards in order for people to keep, you know, keep the economy going. It's my theory, right? So anyway, so that's when I would send you over to a lender. If you're a 550, you've been working for 2 years, you actually have money, or you have plans on getting money. Some people, it depends on who you are though. If you know you can't save and it takes you 6 months to save $1,000, like, come on, you shouldn't go to lender right now. Sorry. But if you know that, I'm pre-approved, I could come up with a couple $1,000s, I'll sacrifice, I'll do whatever it takes, and I'll get that $5,000 or $6,000 that I need to buy this house because I really, really want a house, I'm really motivated, then yeah, I would send you over based off of your motivation, just to see what your score is so that you have all the pieces when you're ready. Because what I hate for people to do is wait 6 months and say, oh, I'll wait six more months and then I'll go try a lender, and then the lender tells you it's another 6 months, and this time you could have been working on your credit. So this is why I try to get, you know, people a plan, a free plan. And if you don't have to pay for credit repair, I will save you the $600 for credit repair. I will do that. You know, this is my service and my value that I provide as a real estate agent for free. For free, you know? So I take the time and talk to people. Even if you want to rent, I'll tell you how to go rent that where you don't, you know, where you don't need to like go through an agent or whatever. Like, I will let you know what's best for you, whatever you want to do. So that's what I would say. If you're 550 and below, then you might want to consider credit repair. If you know that you can't go dispute everything on your own, or like if you know you can't repair your credit by yourself, I don't care if you're a 570, go to credit repair, because if that person can hold you accountable, the $600 you pay is going to save you thousands and thousands of dollars that you will be paying in rent. And people that stay in their leases too long, like, you paying the rent people, like you paying the apartment people or whoever, the landlord, way more money to stay in this lease when you could just, that's 3 more months that you could have been, you know, working on your situation. Okay, so these are the different things that, like, the little nuances where I will help you as an agent. And please don't, feel free to call or text 267-259-4639. We're having a home buying seminar. Ask me about the details. I have one this Saturday, so ask me about the details for that. And you get more, like, I give my buyers a free book that'll walk them through the different phases so they know what's going on. Like, you got to be educated, because if you don't educate yourself, you stand to lose money in this. So it's better to like find the best person that will help you, that will guide you through the process. It's me, right? And then that we have a team that works hard to help you get to your goal. And like, we were out there showing houses yesterday, and they liked the first one. She was like, I will not buy a house for 3 months. I know I'm picky. I was like, but what if I find you a house today? Like, I just said it because I know I can. So I actually did, and I walked through the house. I was like, ooh, this is it. And I know she's gonna say she don't want it, right? And I know we gotta see more. So I said, let's go see more, because I know you're gonna wanna see more. And sure enough, she wanted the house. She wanted to put an offer in. While I showed her the third house, I had my assistant write up the offer and send it over as soon as possible. We move like this. We're just waiting on you to be ready, because I would never rush a person to buy a home. So my name is Ruth Marquise Haynes. Share this video as many places as you can. Tag a friend, let people be educated, help them to be educated on the home buying process or home selling process. If you are a seller out there and you want me to make videos about that, let me know. I'll make it. Let me know what you want to know about. All right. 267-259-4639. I look forward to speaking with you and helping you buy your own home. See you later. Let's get on the contract. Bye.